to gain the power of Dimension X. Stop them!
Welcome back to Retro Wednesday at the Todd Jerry Hangar. This is Mike, and today I want to talk to you about the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle Foot Cruiser. And this is a really cool vehicle, and I'm not so much into the vintage turtles. I'm not going to get every vintage turtle vehicle. But as I've said in the past, I buy the stuff that I think that NECA's not going to make, or Super 7, or the Loyal Subjects, or Playmates. I don't think we're going to see this made by any of those companies. I might be wrong, and if I'm proven wrong, I'm actually going to be very happy about that. But let's go ahead and take a look at the classic, beautiful car, the Foot Cruiser. Coming up! So we're going to take a nice look around this, then we're going to do a lightning round of all of the features, and then we're going to look into each feature a little bit closer, and that's what I think is the best way to take a look at this thing. So it is probably the coolest vehicle out there. I mean, I've already taken a look at the Party Wagon, I've already taken a look at the Blimp, which the Blimp is really kind of a crazy that they made that, but this just looks cool. You know, if you look at Shredder, his crazy pose everyone hates, it actually, so he can fit in here and have a pimp ride, he can just put his hand on that steering wheel, and that works. And you do see him on the box and the packaging, all that kind of stuff, driving it. Or maybe it's not the box, maybe I just always see pictures of it like that. But looking at it from the side, is a lot of chrome all the way through here, and that is not fun. Got chrome on the running board, all around the side. We have chrome all through here. And one of the things that you notice about this is that you're going to see a lot of messed up chrome on a lot of these. So mine's not perfect. I got some spots here and there. But it's pretty good considering the age and what I paid for this. Also, looking at all of this, there's some paint chipping on the purple. That's one of the hardest pieces to get, is good purple. I think that actually pretty much everything else in this can sort of be touched up a little bit, but that purple's almost impossible to match, I would think. I'm not even going to try to match that. There's some stuff you can do with chrome, but it probably not as shiny as original chrome. So, but I'm going to be talking about these wheel covers and all that kind of stuff. So I left one up, one down. We'll be looking at that when we do the hover conversion, when we take it for the hover conversion. But yeah, really cool. And on the back here, we have a license plate that says Danger. We have retro mutagen containment units. So a lot of interesting, cool stuff going on with this, which we will discuss when it comes to the features. Right now, just a quick overview of this, and lots of fun. Okay, features include that it is a 59 Cadillac, and it has a bad to the bone tinted windshield, toe jam and rotating Gatling gun, foot turret weapons pod with a retractable cover. It stows away nicely. Two detachable iSpy missiles. iSpy, nice eyes. Turtle leather steering wheel made with real turtle leather. That's why it warps. Two turtle-seeking antennas, one with a shell crusher. The other one is the turtle killer flags. We have red ooze blasters and blue turtle eliminators, if I'm right. Metalized turtle mulching grill and bumpers, and so, so shiny. Retractable wheels with real foot hubcaps. That is a foot. Disgusting ooze flame graphics on the hood and on the side. Chromed out running boards to hold extra figures with foot pegs, hopefully ones that didn't have too much mutagen. Shell piercing rear fins cuts right through 1988 plastic. And no, it's not a bumper. It is a retro mutagen containment unit. I take it it's the whole rear? Is it the whole rear or just that box? So there's some more unlisted features, such as the control panel in here, the dashboard, that sticker that goes on there that adds kind of like, it's got a turtle detector on it. They got some jams. They listen to some FM radio. Maybe there were some good AM stations back in the day. Maybe AM is where you get the other stations. Okay, so this also is a control panel down here, which is kind of cool. It's a nice sticker. Getting these with good stickers in good condition can be a challenge. Dimension X is probably an AM radio station. So with that, there's a few of these features that I do want to look into a little bit closer. And so let's take a look at this back unit right here. So this foot turret weapons pod plugs into here and making sure that this has all the tabs holding in place, and it folds out, and it's one of those things that you got to have it lined just right. You can close this and have it connected, and then you open it up all of the way, and they could sit in multiple different positions. So I don't think that it's really wise to use the figures I was using on it, so I'm just going to throw Shredder. He's a little lighter. And so with that, he can kind of, as this thing's rolling, shoot the eye missiles if he wants, or operate the Gatling gun, or all of that kind of stuff if he wanted to. And then this can rotate around with him on it, and it's a little easier said than done. Okay, it's really hard. But he can face any direction and that kind of stuff. Really, I think it's meant really to face backwards. It doesn't really make sense to face forward, so it's a backward-facing thing. Also does have a couple of cool stickers on it, which is really cool. Also on the front, you see some turtle stickers right here, and so that's pretty cool there. Now, one of the things that I didn't understand or know about when I first bought this, which I had to buy an extra one of these units, which is why I have another one of these units, was because I didn't know that it had these handles in the back. So there's handles in the back of this here, and with that, they kind of come right off, and they're easily lost. So it doesn't seem like any figures really can hold it that well because they're such small pegs, but it's a nice touch. It's something interesting with the purple and the blue and the gray and all that kind of stuff. It looks pretty good, and it's an extra added fun feature, but I do like how if it's engineered right and everything is, well, it's engineered right. If everything is in working condition and all that kind of stuff, not warped, it closes up and it's all good in the back there. Now, another fun feature, and this is a fun feature in this, is folding down these wheels, and you get a 2015 hover conversion, which is fantastic and fun. And then you can push this button that's right here and that pops down. So then you can have it working as it kind of covers the wheel well. It looks a little bit better. I already have it down on this side, so I'm just going to fold the wheel. You can have it up or down and still fold the wheels, no problem at all. And then he does hover and fly, so you'd want to probably get something to make it look like it's flying. So I'm just going to put it up on an empty star case, like a $2 star case that you put Star Wars figures in, or any 6x9 action figure, and give it the look of flying, and that would work. But there's one more thing that I would like to compare this to before we do real comparisons. I want to compare this to something else that might fly like this. Yo, Doc, do you mean to tell me that foot cruisers are just disappearing everywhere? No, Marty. They're being erased. Erased from existence. I was a man. So for size comparison, here it is next to the Turtle Van. Now, this is the reissue, the most recent reissue, and I would suggest go with the reissue, cheaper than a vintage one. But if you absolutely have to have a vintage one, well, go for a vintage one. But I would love to see this. I have one. I spent the stupid money to get one of these, which was more than I thought it should be. But I like it, and I'd get a reissue of it if I could. Here's how it stacks up size-wise next to an AWE Striker, much, much bigger, and it's also striking. It's a little more fun to look at. This is one of my favorite vintage vehicles, probably my favorite smaller vehicle. The Whale still is my favorite G.I. Joe vehicle by far. Oddly enough, it's about the same length as a vintage Tatooine skiff, so that's pretty cool, pretty interesting. I haven't been showing Star Wars enough love on this channel, so vintage Kenner Star Wars always deserves love. Here it is next to a vintage Talon Fighter from Masters of the Universe. Was one of the Point Dread, something I really loved as a kid. And side by side, not much longer than a Talon Fighter, but Talon Fighter is a bit wider with the wings. But if you take that off, it's actually about the same width as a Talon Fighter without the wings. Here it is next to a future Retro Wednesday, the Silverhawks Mirage. I would say both of these would make a top 10 coolest 80s vehicles list, hands down. Maybe I'm giving too much away. And here it is next to what's probably the best Batmobile that has ever been made, the Kenner 1990, the one I missed by a year because I stopped collecting it in 89. The Kenner 1990 Batmobile. Both really cool. So now that we got this hover converted back, I do want to talk about the fact that these are getting harder to get. They are not quite erased from existence or time, or hard to get, but they're expensive to get. So generally getting a complete one costs you $200, $300 in good condition, and then you can get a beat up one for like 30 bucks missing everything. So a few things that are really hard to get are these antenna with the flags. My flags aren't in the best shape, but I wasn't looking to spend $1 billion on this thing. And then the windshield, which doesn't want to hold in on mine for some reason. So I don't know if that's a thing. Like if you turn it upside down, you're not getting the Dairy Queen guarantee on that one. Also chrome bits, these bits here are hard to find. I see a lot of these for sale, but not with these. That took me a while to find those. So the running board's sometimes missing, but those really aren't the hardest to get. So you can get one and try to piece it together, which is possible, but I say buy one about 75 to 80% complete, only missing a couple of parts, and then maybe either buy another one or just buy a part slot that has the few parts you're missing. And that's the best way to go. And still, you could just be happy with one missing a few pieces, because I don't really think it's the end of the world. But it's a really cool set, so definitely worth picking up. So this is my Retro Wednesday look at the Foot Cruiser from the 1988, 89, whenever they put this thing out. And the thing about it is that I don't think, like I said before, NECA or Super 7 or any of them are going to make one, or not Playmates. We're not going to see a reissue of this. We've seen the van a few times. I don't think we've ever seen this. We're obviously not going to get the Channel News, whatever, Channel 7 News Wagon or whatever channel that is, Channel 6 News Wagon, and all of those kinds of things ever again. So some of the harder pieces to get in vintage are just going to get harder because they're probably not going to put those out. I don't see them doing this. Do you think they will do this? And do you have one of these? Did you have one of these as a kid? I never had one as a kid. I saw other people with them and thought it was kind of cool, but at the same time kind of dorky because I liked stuff like that DeLorean way more. But now I have much fonder appreciation for this. And if you had this, let me know. If you have one of these now, do you like it? And do you think it will get remade by any of these companies at all for whatever price point? Let me know in the comments below. Like and subscribe. Teddy Ringer out.
I'm trying!